It's time for the weekly No Pain, No Gain market update with a team at Payne Capital Management here in New York City.
Good morning. This is Bob Payne, Chief Investment Strategist at Payne Capital Management. And the Federal Reserve on Wednesday raised interest rates in a widely expected move and indicated it would do so again in its December meeting, as well as three more times next year. Now, in response, the 10-year Treasury bond yield climbed to 3.12%. That's a 52-week high, and mortgage rates are now close to 5%. That's still a very attractive rate on mortgages when you compare it to the 21% mortgage rate that I paid for my first home way back in the early 80s. Now, the Fed also raised its gross domestic product growth forecast for 2018 and 2019. Meanwhile, the Commerce Department said that the second quarter GDP rose at a 4.2% annualized rate. Now, that's unchanged from the earlier estimate. In addition, jobless claims remain near multi-decade lows, and orders for durable goods rose 4.5%. Now, that's faster than was expected. So on the economy, all good news. Now, on Thursday, trading volume on the exchange actually dropped as investors took a day off from trading to watch the testimony of Supreme Court nominee Brett Kavanaugh and Dr. Christine Blasey Ford. Now, the hearing, of course, has no direct relevance to the economy, although some pundits believe that the outcome could influence the turnout in the upcoming midterm elections. As for the markets, well, oil and especially natural gas prices rose on the week. The dollar moved higher, and most stocks and bonds were unchanged on the week. But they finished strong for the month and closed out the third quarter with solid gains.